all these ranches kind of affect the local economy, especially like Fallon and a lot of these small towns that these operations are in?
Well, it happens in multiple scenarios. And one is, it's just the bare roots, actual people enjoying the resource. We share the same areas that ATV people utilize. For instance, I use an example very close to here, the Sand Mountain area. Okay, that area is all BLM. It also sits on top of several active BLM grazing permits, and we all share that. So that's really important that we can utilize that ground. And I can't tell those ATV people to not go on the grazing, and they can't tell the cattlemen to stay off. The cattle industry, families have the grazing permits to graze on there that they actually pay for, okay? The other side of that is that we're standing here today at Fallon Livestock LLC, local sale barn, and they're selling cattle. So Tommy Lee owns it, Tommy and Nora Lee. They have people that are working here, part of the industry, selling cattle, and those people, when they leave here, they go into Fallon, and they may buy commodities, may buy groceries, may buy a car at Fallon Auto Mall, what have you. So that's the economy that grazing can create. So not only being able to utilize the public lands for recreation, but also the jobs that are created by that. Our family, we have to pay several individuals to help us. We can't do it all by ourselves. So we pay those individuals to go out and ride, help us gather, and we pay them a check. And they take that money and go into town and hopefully buy a vehicle, groceries, what have you.
Perfect. Thank you so much for that information.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of the questions that especially young people have, or at least I have as a young rancher, is that there's a lot of information out there and a lot that we all need to know. And so I'm going to ask you, where can a young person go to either get their voice heard or get some advice on how to stay up to date with a lot of the issues that are going on, especially politically, economically, anything that's outside of just waking up at 6 a.m. and going out and doing your job on the ranch?
Okay. Well, the first way, and it's not for everybody, is to go to an agricultural school, whether it be a community college or a full university, and work on that, because they have a lot of resources and they're going to have a lot of opportunities for you to look at what's beyond the college once you get out. If college is not where you want to go, then I suggest going into a small town like Fallon. And Fallon is really good because it does have the two sale yards. And there's nothing wrong with young people coming down to like Tommy and Nora's sale here and sitting in here and watching what goes on inside this sale barn. You're going to be able to see the people that are buying a lot of cattle. You know those people probably have some kind of an influence in the community and probably know quite a bit. There's all kinds of resources. You have your county extension service. Churchill County is still, because it does have a lot of agriculture, Churchill County does have a good extension agency. And that was intended for this very thing. The county extension agencies was a resource for people to learn. Not only people that weren't in agriculture, but people in agriculture.
Perfect. Do you have any final thoughts or kind of closing advice that you have for people? Just anything you want to say to kind of our audience about the importance of what we do in the ag industry, especially cow-calf operations?
Well, I think the big thing I would leave with young people is to know that public grazing is so important that without it, a community like Fallon would be much different in the way it looks. Any good economy needs to have a multitude of different kinds of businesses are surrounding it. And if you were to take out the public grazing part, things would look a lot different. And that's why we always partner with people like our recreational folks to make them understand that if you can't have agriculture, then what's going to be next? The recreation will be next. So it's really important. The other thing we haven't touched on really at all either is there's been a lot of discussion about fires over these past 2 years. This last year, for instance, was a horrendous year, and that is really an important thing for grazing to help keep those fires and the fire danger down at a minimum. But it's really important to have public grazing, very important for our overall agriculture economy, not only in Nevada but in America.
Well, Davey, thank you so much for your time and for a boatload of information. If you guys like these kinds of videos and want to keep following along, please like and share. And once again, I'm Claire McKay, working with the Nevada Rangeland Resources Commission to bring all of this information to you. So if you have any questions, please feel free to comment them or just find me on the street. Y'all know where I live. So with that, we'll see you at the next one.